Bemidbar, chapter 21. And the sovereign of Arad, the Canaanite who dwelt in the south, heard that Israel was coming on the way to Atharim, and he fought against Israel and took some of them captive. Then Israel made a vow to Yahweh and said, If you deliver this people into my hand indeed, then I shall put their cities under the ban. And Yahweh listened to the voice of Israel and gave up the Canaanites, and they put them and their cities under the ban. So the name of that place was called Chormah. And they departed from Mount Hor by the way of the Sea of Reeds to go around the land of Edom. But the being of the people grew impatient because of the way. And the people spoke against Elohim and against Moshe. Why have you brought us up out of Mitzrayim to die in the wilderness? For there is no food and no water, and our being loathes this light bread. And Yahweh sent fiery serpents among the people, and they bit the people, and many of the people of Israel died. Then the people came to Moshe and said, We have sinned, for we have spoken against Yahweh and against you. Pray to Yahweh to take away the serpents from us. So Moshe prayed on behalf of the people, and Yahweh said to Moshe, Make a fiery serpent, and set it on a pole, and it shall be that everyone who is bitten, when he looks at it, shall live. So Moshe made a bronze serpent, and put it on a pole, and it came to be, if a serpent had bitten anyone, when he looked at the bronze serpent, he lived. And the children of Israel set out and camped in Ovoth, and they departed from Ovoth, and camped at Iyeh ha-Avarim, in the wilderness which is east of Moab, toward sunrise. From there they set out and camped at the Wadi Zered. From there they set out and camped on the other side of the Arnon, which is in the wilderness that extends from the border of the Amorites, for the Arnon is the border of Moab between Moab and the Amorites. Therefore it is said in the book of the battles of Yahweh, Wahev in Sufa, the Wadi Arnon, and the slope of the Wadi that turns aside to the dwelling of Ar, and lies on the border of Moab. And from there on to Be'er, which is the well where Yahweh said to Moshe, Gather the people, and let me give them water. Israel then sang this song, Spring up, O well, sing to it, a well the leaders sank, which the nobles of the people dug with their staves, by the word of the inscriber. Then from the wilderness on to Matanah, from Matanah to Nachaliel, from Nachaliel to Bamoth, and from Bamoth in the valley that is in the country of Moab, to the top of Pisgah, which looks down on the wasteland. And Israel sent messengers to Sihon, sovereign of the Amorites, saying, Let me pass through your land. We shall not turn off into fields or vineyards, we shall not drink water from wells, but go by the sovereign's highway until we have passed over your border. But Sihon would not allow Israel to pass through his border. So Sihon gathered all his people together and went out against Israel in the wilderness, and he came to Yahatz and fought against Israel. And Israel struck him with the edge of the sword and took possession of his land from the Arnon to the Yabbok, as far as the children of Ammon, for the border of the children of Ammon was strong. And Israel took all these cities, and Israel dwelt in all the cities of the Amorites, in Heshbon and in all its villages. For Heshbon was the city of Sihon, the sovereign of the Amorites, who had fought against the former sovereign of Moab, and had taken all his land from his hand as far as the Arnon. That is why those who speak in Proverbs say, Come to Heshbon, let the city of Sihon be built and established. For fire went out from Heshbon, a flame from the city of Sihon. It consumed Ar of Moab, the masters of the heights of the Arnon. Woe to you, Moab! You have perished, O people of Chemosh! He has given his sons as fugitives, and his daughters into captivity, to Sihon, the sovereign of the Amorites. Then we shot them. Heshbon has perished as far as Divon, and we laid waste as far as Nophach, which reaches to Medeva. So Israel dwelt in the land of the Amorites, and Moshe sent to spy out Yazer, and they took its villages and drove out the Amorites who were there, and turned and went up by the way to Bashan. And Og, sovereign of Bashan, went out against them, he and all his people, to battle at Edrei. And Yahweh said to Moshe, Do not fear him, for I have given him into your hand, with all his people and his land, and you shall do to him as you did to Sihon, sovereign of the Amorites, who dwelt at Heshbon. And they struck him and his sons and all his people, until no remnant was left to him, and they took possession of his land.